Wednesday morning, the 16th of June, Lou M. with the WHIO Morning Show. Here's a great idea for a great evening from the folks at the Golden Lamb in Lebanon, Ohio. Dinner patrons at the Golden Lamb are invited to be their guests at the Lebanon Raceway Monday through Thursdays. All you have to do is ask for your complimentary guest ticket to the Lebanon Raceway. And just so you won't be disappointed, they suggest you make your dinner reservation in advance. Now, post time is 8:15, so you see there's plenty of time to enjoy your dinner at the Golden Lamb and still make the first race. After the races, there's no better place than the Golden Lamb for a discussion of the evening's events over a refreshing beverage. Now remember, make your dinner reservations at the Golden Lamb well in advance. That way you're not disappointed. Dinner at the Golden Lamb, Ohio's oldest inn and restaurant in Lebanon, Ohio. And during the current season, Mondays through Thursdays, receive a complimentary guest ticket to the Lebanon Raceway, courtesy of the Golden Lamb. They say the thrills are yours, the pleasure's ours. I'd say that's a winning ticket to a great all-around evening. This is WHIO 1290 in Dayton, your kind of radio. Is your auto license number on this week's Ohio Jackpot winners list? Check by Saturday, you may win a prize. Or mail your Ohio auto license number by Saturday to Box 5428, Cleveland, Ohio. WHIO Total News at 7, presented by Homestead Federal Savings, where interest is compounded daily on certificate plans. With the news, here's Winston Hayner.
Good morning, everyone. The city of Wilmington, Ohio, will play host to representatives from 14 federal agencies today and tomorrow for a series of meetings on the future of the Clinton County Air Force Base. The base is scheduled to be closed September 30th as part of a Defense Department economy move. A committee of area businessmen has urged that the base be used as a vocational school and industrial park. A citizen advisory committee on cable TV working under the direction of the Council of Governments has recommended that political subdivisions in the Miami Valley freeze all cable TV franchise applications until the end of the year. This will permit further study by the RAND Corporation with grants from the Kettering and Ford Foundations on the possible ramifications and possibilities of cable TV in the area. Corporation analyst Robert Yin says the group is looking currently into a two-cable system with up to 40 channels. There still is no further word on the missing C-135 transport jet assigned to Wright-Patterson Air Force Base. The plane has been missing since Sunday on a flight in the Pacific Ocean near Hawaii. 24 passengers and crewmen, 8 from the Miami Valley, were on a mission which was not disclosed by the Air Force. Bad weather is hampering efforts to inspect debris found in an area where the plane may have gone down. Dayton's mayor, James McGee, is attending a conference of mayors in Philadelphia today, which means the city commission has delayed its scheduled meeting tonight until tomorrow night. Also attending the U.S. mayor's conference is Cleveland's mayor, Carl Stokes. In an interview, Stokes was asked if the resolutions coming out of the conference really boil down to more money for cities.
You see, they just, I hate to be so simplistic, and they certainly do also, but they cannot get to the other problems unless they have the money to do it with. You don't get the management capability, et cetera, unless you get over the question of whether or not you can hire people.
What about, or why would the mayors venture into foreign affairs, into Vietnam?
The only reason that they have ventured into it is because of the terrible drain that it has placed upon the funds which otherwise ought to be appropriated for the desperately needed domestic needs.
And so spoke Carl Stokes at yesterday's mayor's conference, which is being held in Philadelphia. The New York Times has agreed to obey a temporary court order and halt publication of material from a secret Pentagon study on the Vietnam War. Senate Majority Leader Mike Mansfield says a secret report on American involvement in Indochina will be made public through congressional hearings, even if the courts block its newspaper publication. The Senate votes today on a proposal to cut off funding for U.S. involvement in Indochina, the proposal expected to be defeated. Calm has returned to Albuquerque, New Mexico, after 2 days of violence in which 15 persons were wounded by gunfire and more than 600 arrested. Soviet Communist Party Chief Leonid Brezhnev says the Big Four talks in the West Berlin have advanced substantially to the stage where, in the Soviet leader's words, concrete proposals on the content of a possible agreement can be examined. Brezhnev spoke this morning before the East German Communist Party Congress in East Berlin. Donald Peterson was operating a dump truck at a construction site in Lincoln, Nebraska yesterday when a high-voltage electric line fell on the vehicle and the electricity burned off the truck's tires. Patterson, trapped inside for about 30 minutes, was not injured, but a little nervous. The Vatican has ordered all priests to say Mass using the new liturgy developed after the Vatican Ecumenical Council. The order, issued yesterday in Rome by the Congregation for the Divine Cult, takes effect as soon as local bishops have approved a translation of the Mass into the vernacular. I'll be back with the weather after this.
Leaping lizards, it's Little Orphan Annie. Homestead Federal brought Daddy Warbucks and Annie to town several months ago to tell you about two things. One, that Homestead pays you money in advance. And two, that Homestead compounds interest daily on all certificate plans. Both are the kind of ideas that smart money managers like Daddy Warbucks use to make sure that their money makes money. If you haven't heard about interest in advance, here's what it's all about. Put $10,000 in Homestead's check a month plan. Homestead will give you a check for $46.15, your first month's interest in advance. Want a bigger check? Well, we'll check with any Homestead Savings Center downtown, in Belmont, or the new Oak Creek Shopping Center for details. Just tell them Big Daddy sent you.
Mostly sunny today and tomorrow, highs in the low to mid-80s, clear tonight with a low in the upper 50s, and currently at WHIO 62 degrees.
You've heard Total News at 7 with Winston Hayner, presented by Homestead Federal Savings, where you can get first month's interest in advance with a check-a-month account. Portions of the preceding program mechanically reproduced. Our next regularly scheduled newscast at 7:30 on WHIO 1290 in Dayton, the station that brings you traffic reports each morning with Police Captain Russ Guerra.
Wolf Roads at this particular moment.
Where did you say you were, Russell?
At Salem and Wolf Roads, old daddy.
Okay, sounds like you're frying bacon. Say you can save during the big Genie Garage Door Opener Father's Day sale going on right now. Get a genuine Genie Automatic Garage Door Opener System by Alliance, just $98.44 plus a modest installation. Only $98.44 at Dayton Door Sales at 1115 Springfield Street. Now don't wait. Call Dayton Door Sales 254-3513 at 115 Springfield Street today. The number again is 254-3513, Dayton Door Sales. Troy Springfield area, call 845-0001. Out of town, call collect. Well, the Bogey Busters tournament is history, and I'm still got a no-hitter going. Andy Williams leaves the city, and with him the gratitude of those who had a chance to hear him sing and perform, and also with the knowledge that the fight against multiple sclerosis is $40,000 richer, due in no small part to Andy's appearance here in Dayton. So bon voyage, and I think we all have an Andy Williams favorite. Hope you don't mind, I'll play mine.
Oh, once in my life, I have someone who needs me, someone I've needed so long. For once, unafraid, I can go where life leads me. Somehow I know I'll be strong. For once, I can touch what my heart used to dream of long before I knew. Whoa, someone warm like you would make my dreams come true. Yeah, 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 yeah. Once in my life, I won't let sorrow hurt me, not like it's hurt me. Dreamer!
Hurry back, Andy. Right now it's 9 minutes and 15 seconds past 7 o'clock. Up and at 'em time, the 16th of June. The temperature at 62 and beautiful weather. Sunny today and tomorrow, high each day in the low to mid-80s. Captain Russ Guerra has cleared his throat, and he'll be reporting on traffic in 60 seconds.
The more you know, the more you want, Delco.
When you think about it, your car's brakes aren't so very much different from the shoes you're wearing. After carrying you here and there, mile after endless mile, they eventually wear a little thin. When they do, you should do something about it. And the way to make sure you're getting new brake shoes, as well as new brake linings, is to ask for Delco. Delco brake shoes are properly shaped and finished to make adjustment quieter and easier. And they have a unique feature called crown grind finishing to make the break-in period easier for you, because they are engineered to prevent pulling to the right or left. And Delco brakes fit all American-made cars and most foreign ones, too. So if your car needs a brake job, look for the red, white, and blue Delco sign. The more you know, the more you'll want Delco.
The more you know, the more you'll want Delco.
Okay, all things clear. Let's go to the Air Scout helicopter, and here's Captain Marvel.
We're on Siebenthaler, just proceeding south. We're going to head on down as far as Germantown and check Gettysburg in its entirety, because there's not too much else stirring anyplace else. Traffic is light, and we still have no reported accidents. I don't want you to think that I'm disappointed because I don't have any accidents. I think this is great. I'd like to go the whole day without any accidents. And as a result, then, our traffic is moving smoothly on all of the streets that are being used at the moment. Over here at Gettysburg and King's Highway, not too much there. We look ahead of ourselves on down past Cornell and Western Avenue. We have a little bit of traffic there at Gettysburg and Western, but the traffic light is handling that properly. And then we kind of lose Gettysburg in the haze or mist or fog or whatever you want to call it. So we'll have to get a little closer to 3rd Street before we can tell you what that looks like there. The railroad crossing here, the Pennsylvania Railroad crossing, or what used to be Pennsylvania Railroad crossing, is clear in both directions as far as we can see. So you guys down around Rosedale and Riverview and through there shouldn't have any problem getting to work there at Dayton Tire and Rubber. We have just checked the county radio. That is working properly. We've had no accidents reported over there, so we'll assume then that things are in good shape throughout the entire greater Dayton area. While we're assuming, then here comes old Lou M.
And it's 12 and a half minutes now after 7 o'clock.
This message is from the makers of Cadillac Motor Cars and your authorized Cadillac dealer. It's about traffic safety, a thing that Cadillac has always taken seriously. Did you know, for instance, that Cadillac was the first to install safety glass back in 1928? Or that it was Cadillac who introduced the triple braking system in 1962? Or that the 1971 Cadillac incorporates a host of recent safety advances, like the energy-absorbing steering column, side guard steel beams in the doors, and many others. But even though Cadillac is committed to making its cars as safe as possible, there are still some things that only you can do. 1. Always use your seat belt and shoulder belt. 2. Make sure your car is in good running order. 3. Never drive when you're tired out or under the influence of alcohol. Thank you. From Cadillac, a car with the General Motors mark of excellence.
Tony Mottola. 63 degrees. Mostly sunny today and tomorrow. It'll be up into the mid-80s this afternoon and 63 at the moment. Brenda Moore's, Ohio's largest sporting goods equipment chain, brings you sports. Brenda Moore's, your complete sports center at the Dayton Mall on the Mezzanine and 114 North Main Street in Dayton. The St. Louis Cardinals snapped a 7-game losing streak last night when they trounced Cincinnati 6-1. The Cards' Reggie Cleveland fired a 3-hitter, and 3 home runs from the Cardinals' bats made the difference. The homers produced 4 runs off Jim Merritt, who now stands at 0-8 for the season. The Reds will meet the Cards again this afternoon in St. Louis, broadcast time on WHIO radio, beginning at 1 o'clock. The pace setter in the National League East, Pittsburgh, kept going as Steve Blass pitched a 3-0 shutout over the Houston Astros. San Francisco, front runner in the National League West, shut out Philadelphia 6-0 on a 4-hitter by Ron Bryant. Los Angeles, the victor over the New York Mets, 2-0. The San Diego Padres squeezed by Montreal, 3-1. In the only day game, it was Chicago over Atlanta, 3-1, thanks to Bill Hand's 3-hitter. In the American League, though, it was a night for home runs. Milwaukee edged Baltimore 6-5 on a 9th-inning home run by Johnny Briggs. The Orioles got 2 homers in the first inning by Frank and Brooks Robinson. A 2-run homer by Bobby Mercer led the New York Yankees to a 2-1 decision over Kansas City. Chicago's Bill Melton belted a bases-loaded homer to help the Chicago White Sox to a 6-1 victory over Detroit. Minnesota got home runs from Tony Oliva, Rich Rees, and Brad Allie as they beat Cleveland 5-3. Sid O'Brien pinch hit a 2-run homer in the bottom of the 9th inning, and California came away with a win over Boston 5-4. Oakland ripped the Washington Senators 8-2. Well, the U.S. Open begins tomorrow in Ardmore, Pennsylvania on the Marion Golf Course, and the 1968 Open winner, Lee Trevino, calls it the toughest course he's ever seen. He says it takes that honor away from the Firestone course up in Akron. But two-time Open winner Billy Casper disagrees. He says it's a pretty good course, but he feels if the weather is good, a new scoring record for the Open could be set, and that record is a 275. Who has it? It's shared by Jackie Nicklaus and Lee Trevino. Father's Day this coming Sunday, so a visit to Brenda Moore's is in order today. Brenda Moore's, the full-line, full-service sporting goods stores, are featuring a number of items, especially priced for Dad's Day. Now, for the fisherman in your family, a deluxe fishing vest, water repellent, 12 pockets with fly holder, rod holder, and detachable mesh creel. They're priced at just $7.98. Now, for the hunter or gun collector, here's an item he'll cherish for life. A Winchester NRA commemorative rifle. Now, it's the model 94 with lever action and walnut stock. Brenda Moore's has just a few of these superb guns, and they're priced at $149.95. If hiking is popular in your family, the new nylon backpack is perfect. It has a lightweight magnesium frame, 6 outside pockets, in addition to the main carrying compartment, and adjustable back band for comfort, priced at $21.98. Now, these and many more items, too numerous to mention, are yours. You can select them at Brenda Moore's, on the mezzanine at the Dayton Mall, and downtown at 114 North Main, where they have 2 full floors of quality sporting equipment.
The two of us. Woody Allen.
I was watching one night the Ed Sullivan show, and Sullivan had on a hypnotist called the great Ronaldo. And Ronaldo got 4 guys out of the audience and he hypnotized them. And he said to them, "You think you're a fire engine." And I'm home watching and I get drowsy and I fall asleep. And I wake up an hour later, I turn the set off. And suddenly I'm seized with an uncontrollable impulse to dress up in my red flannel underwear. Which I do when I'm looking at myself in the mirror. And suddenly the phone rings. I burst out the front door and start running down Fifth Avenue fast, making a siren noise. At 14th Street, I hit a guy at an intersection who was also wearing red flannel underwear. We decided to work as one truck. We start running down to the Village. Suddenly, 2 guys in red flannel underwear pass us, running uptown. We figure they must know where the fire is. We turn and follow. At 86th Street, a cop flags us down because there's 4 guys in red flannel underwear running up the street. He says, "You're coming down to headquarters. Get into the car." And I start giggling hysterically because this jerk is trying to get a fire engine into a lousy little Chevy.
If you still think home loan interest rates are high, listen to this.
That's the sound of home loan interest rates going down. And you know who first started pushing home loan rates down in Dayton? Citizens Federal Savings. Way back in October of last year. And Citizens Federal's been pushing home loan rates down ever since. Even the rates on VA and FHA loans have come down, though we can't honestly take credit for that. So, if you've been putting off buying a home because you thought interest rates were still up, you don't have a reason to wait any longer. See your real estate man about that new home this week. Then, come see Citizens Federal about the loan, conventional, VA, or FHA. We make them all at Citizens Federal Savings, the convenient home loan centers.
Well, it's almost 21 minutes after 7, 63 degrees, and it doesn't take long to hear from an audience. We played Andy Williams for Once in My Life, my choice. Now a lady requested her choice. We find no argument in that.
Moon River, wider than a mile, I'm crossing you in style someday.
I don't think it'll ever make it, though.
Oh, dream maker, you heartbreaker, wherever you're going, I'm going your way. The same rainbows end, waiting round the bend, my huckleberry friend, Moon River, and
Three degrees here at 23 and a half minutes after 7. Lou M. with the WHIO Morning Show. Now, as a public service, Allegheny Airlines, with new nonstop fanjet service to St. Louis, brings you this traffic report from the WHIO Air Scout helicopter. Here's Russ.
Thank you. We're out over the eastern section of the city, just approaching Harshman Road at the railroad crossing. And as we work our way a little bit closer to Wright-Patterson Air Force Base through the fog and all, we'll comment just briefly. We ran into BW last night down at the Kenley Players. And he was still talking about the show the other night with Andy Williams and all. It was truly a fantastic show. And old BW is skinny again. I asked him how he did it, and it's some kind of a liquid diet that he's got. I tried that one time, and the only thing that happened, my nose turned red. I'll have to try something else, I guess. The traffic out in this area, now that we're here, we can see it. The traffic on Harshman Road is moving across, no interruption. The railroad crossing is clear, and the movement out here is very good. Boy, they're just circulating right through here like crazy. Of course, nobody's stopping and going to work. They're just out here circulating. We still can't see the main gate at the right field. It's coming into view here, but it's still quite a bit of glare and all. We can't really see it. Chuck is listening to approach control out there to make sure they don't sneak some of our friendly Air Force out here, some of their big fast jobs to scare us half to death. But the traffic outbound on the old Route 4, on 444, is moving along well, and doesn't seem to be any tie-ups here by the gate. We can't see Huffman Road yet. We're right over Eastwood Park, but we can't see the intersection of Huffman Road. The traffic coming from 4, the cutover from 4 over to 444, this is moving along pretty well. We can see the clover leaf there, and there's no tie-up there, and there's no backup. It seems to be moving steadily. So what we can see out here does look good. I think I'm going to make a turn here and go back over to the Air Force Museum and get back over to Woodman Drive. We checked 35 inbound. This looked good. Still no reported traffic accidents in the area, so let's get back down to our host and your host, Lou M.
Jet the Allegheny Air System to St. Louis, Pittsburgh, Philadelphia, Hartford, Springfield, or New York.
The Allegheny Air System. The Allegheny Air System has a lot more going for you.
Fly Allegheny's new nonstop fan jet service to St. Louis, featuring a convenient 6:09 p.m. dinner fan jet. And to Pittsburgh, the only nonstop fan jets are Allegheny's. We also have one-stop fan jets to Philadelphia, Hartford, Springfield, and New York's close-in LaGuardia Airport. And when you jet Allegheny, you get jet custom class service. It's all one class.
The Allegheny Air System. There's a lot more going for you.
Allegheny has a convenient early morning breakfast fan jet to Hartford, Springfield, leaving at 7:40. Jet custom service at comparable jet coach fares. Well, pressure systems continue to be quite weak this morning. Lower pressure is over Kentucky and Tennessee, but generally high pressure over the Great Lakes. Mostly sunny skies forecast for Ohio today. Locally, sunny today and tomorrow. High each day in the low to mid-80s, the overnight low in the upper 50s. Humidity at 95%, our temperature at 63 degrees. Total news at 7:30, that's 3 minutes hence.